My name is Gary Blotto Valley. I am a lecturer in the NTID Science and Mathematics Department. I currently teach math full-time to deaf and hard of hearing students. My part with the Deaf Tech grant is creating an online database of mathematical tutoring videos similar to Khan Academy or other online resources, but created specifically for deaf and hard of hearing students and people who teach them or their parents. Creating these online tutorials started with me creating videos for my students in my classes, creating 5 to 20 minute being the absolute max, video segments of me demonstrating a math concept and then explaining it in sign language, but I do it consecutively. So the videos do take longer than other videos, but the information is portrayed in a way that students can access both the demonstration and the explanation much easier than other tools out there.
I sent a wide value to see if they satisfy the system.
This isn't meant to be a standalone math teaching tool. It's meant to guide and tutor, much like other online resources do. So in the workshop, participants will see some examples of what's out there and then what we've created at Deaf Tech, and then we'll walk through watching some of the video modules and then doing some practice problems, which I will be hooking up with Khan Academy with their online practice sets.
We're gonna go through a system of two equations.
Once we finish that, we'll talk about some of the frustrations, talk about what went well, some of the Khan Academy frustrations with putting in answers online for math questions, and talk about who benefits from this. It's not just the deaf student, it's the deaf student's parent who maybe doesn't know how to sign or explain things in terms of mathematics, or the teacher of the deaf who is in the school for the deaf or in this mainstream setting who maybe isn't a math teacher, or the interpreter in the classroom who may not know the right signs to choose or the conceptually accurate way to explain something.
-4, -3. If we were to replace the x and y value.
As far as my experience with creating these video modules, it came out of the realization that the classroom instruction, while you know I believe it's spectacular, wasn't enough overall. The students needed some type of resource to look at back in their dorm, right? Each college students back in their dorm room, back in their apartment, if they had forgotten what I said in class or if they're confused on a point. So this was a resource that they can access that's built specifically for them. So these video modules I've used as tutorials, as support for lectures that already happened. And as I created more and more of them, I actually used them as pre-instructional material. So a student may go watch the videos, do some practice problems, come to class, and then in class we tackle the more difficult problems.
Your tracks are down here. There's two video tracks.
There's a whole new approach for some students. They think of YouTube and videos and whatnot as entertainment, and now we're using that tool to educate.